What is it that left a YouTuber with over a million subscribers with a consistent view count of millions and arguably the potential to be one of the biggest commentators to stop uploading on this platform? For over a year, the YouTuber Pramink has been missing, well, at least on YouTube, who hasn't uploaded since March 18th, 2020. To be clear though, Pramink has not been completely off the internet. He's still active on Twitter, as you can see by his likes, and tweeting every now and then. However, I hope I can help figure out why Pramink decided to stop uploading for over a year and find evidence and the reason he hasn't been on the platform YouTube. First of all, who is Pramink? For those who don't know, Pramink is a commentary channel who has amassed a large following, creating videos on other YouTube content creators explaining his distaste with them or the decline of their channel. His first video came out in early 2018 where he criticized the YouTuber Patty Mayo for pretending to be a bounty hunter. He thought the interactions Patty Mayo would get were not genuine. He actually found evidence of Patty Mayo and his girlfriend creating a casting call for the job. This casting call was for the actors that were in Patty Mayo's videos. He would actually receive severe backlash from Patty Mayo fans, with the original video getting over 25,000 dislikes. He would continue to upload this style of content and make connections with other commentary channels such as The Right Opinion. I really want to say Pramink found his niche with his own video style when he uploaded how Shane Dawson destroyed this YouTuber. Ever since then, the Pramink channel has had a large steady incline. I mean, look at the views Pramink was pulling by just talking about other content creators. Pramink has a very unique personality when compared to other commentators. A big part of his success is that he actually seems to care about what he's talking about when making his videos. He would start to build a very friendly and genuine community. You can tell by his YouTube comments on his recent video that his fans long for his return. Very few YouTubers can build a healthy relationship with their audience. With all these positive going to the Pramink channel, what would be the reason he would decide not to upload for over a year? Many YouTubers who have made similar videos to this one believe Pramink was sued in a lawsuit because he discussed other content creators' drama, or that he's still on YouTube but goes by a different name. In fact, many people think Pramink is behind the channel called Sister Zio. Sister Zio makes similar content to Pramink and somewhat of a similar editing style. Many people believe Sister Zio and Pramink have a similar voice, but that's only if you're really trying to hear it. I can see maybe why you can come to this conclusion, but I think it's out the question. Like, why would Pramink go to the length of creating an entirely new channel? This one is definitely a stretch and people just trying to grab anything they can. So do I believe any of these theories to be true? No, not at all. Pramink has talked about getting sued on Twitter, but it was nothing more than a joke. These are nothing more than really bad theories. When someone goes missing and there isn't a crystal clear explanation, people will try to fill in the answers, whether those answers actually make sense at all. He does have a second channel, but all he uploaded was a Q&A, which was over a year ago. He answered all the basic YouTuber Q&A questions, revealing to his audience that his real name is Kyle in this video. I think this video really reveals why Pramink is so popular and why his audience misses him so much. Pramink has a very welcoming and warm personality. He easily entertains you, and he's also pretty funny. Also, I guess people really enjoy his voice and giggles, even creating timestamps of when he does them. Anyways, besides all the conspiracy theories and questions on why Pramink stopped uploading, the real answer is actually surprisingly really simple. Burnout. Burnout is a state of emotional, physical, and mental exhaustion caused by excessive and prolonged stress. It occurs when you feel overwhelmed, emotionally drained, and unable to meet constant demands. With gaining popularity, there's a lot of comebacks with it. There is a lot of eyes on him, and sometimes people just need time. Time to relax or pursue other interests. You know, Pramink is not obligated to give his time to anyone but himself. Plus, uploading on YouTube can become very stressful, and creating a well-researched video takes a lot of effort. Finding an interesting video topic that will do well for your channel, well-in-depth research, making an interesting script, recording your audio, hours and hours of editing, thumbnail making, and more. With this, I completely understand how Pramink could get burnout and wanting a break. Now, a break that lasts over a year is extremely long, so there could be other factors, but Pramink hasn't mentioned any of that, and I'm not the type to put on the tinfoil hat and guess. According to a thread I found on Reddit, Pramink confirmed he was on a break on his Discord server. Also, a comment on one of Pramink's community tabs read this: "For everyone wondering where Pramink is, if he's okay, he is okay. He's just on break. Information from a Discord mod." It would go on to say he's just taking a break. It's best for him to do what he thinks he needs to be done. And begging for someone's time doesn't mean they're obligated to give it to you. You can always join his Discord server for more updates and slash or more information. Going back to the Sister Zio theory, why would Pramink upload on a separate channel and put days into creating a video when he's on break? I really believe it to be that simple, and I won't try to find any other motives on why Pramink stopped uploading. Regardless though, he definitely has many people anticipating his return to this platform. Pramink did a lot of good with his videos, whether that be entertaining a major audience or actually holding the right people accountable for their actions. Pramink's last tweet on his public Twitter account would be on April 20th, 2020. He talked about a wild bird that got into his house, and other than that, a reply that he made on the 27th of April. Ever since then, he hasn't tweeted out since. But like I said earlier, he's still active on the platform, regularly liking tweets. Even though many people on Reddit think there's other factors going on, I don't think we have to worry. If there were other factors, Pramink would probably rather keep them private, and I respect that. I hope all is well with Pramink, and I hope he takes as much time as he needs for his return. Since he took this long break, I assume he feels a lot of pressure for his next upload, but Pramink should know he has a really caring community that would be satisfied with any work he decides to put out. Anyways, this pretty much sums up the information on what happened to Pramink. Burnout is a real thing, and taking a break and a step back can always help. The YouTuber Tiffany Ferg sums up the main idea of this video perfectly with her "Why do popular YouTubers disappear?" Take care, Pramink. I'm Brio. Let's keep it at that.
Next reasons, you may lose passion, run out of ideas, or burn out. This is pretty self-explanatory, but it is very hard to try to be creative and be entertaining on a consistent basis. Throughout the years, the upload expectations on YouTube have changed. It used to be multiple times a week, and now, you know, once or twice a week is pretty standard. But even then, to consistently be expected back to back to always have great new ideas, better than before, it's just really hard. It's hard to constantly be putting out new things, feel like you have new things to say or new things to present, when really we're not that interesting. There's usually not that much inspiration that strikes, you know, week to week. Maybe creators are just not passionate about YouTube as a platform anymore, or maybe they just feel too stuck in the genre or style of video where they gained most of their viewers and therefore feel like they have to stay in that, because if they move outside of that, people might unsubscribe.